everybody, welcome back to GDPG.
What's up?
And today we are playing Animal Inspector. Ooh.
I'm so excited.
These two don't know what this game is.
No,
I've played it already. But
I got roped into this.
The developer is this person bloop, on the screen. Because I forgot to look before we recorded.
We weren't sure what we were going to record because I'm not here as frequently. And Chris is like, I have the perfect game! And then pulled this up, and I know nothing about it.
And she loves animals.
So much.
So
desperately love it. So,
okay. It starts off, we're given a newspaper that says, too many animals! Government declares animal crisis! Gun Fancy, the last buck, meet its hunter!
Florida teen builds our lovers. That's fun. Hunting in a world without wild animals.
Oh my.
Alright, that might give us a clue into what's going on.
Big scoop, please don't kill me! Photos leaked, secret plans revealed. The president wants your pets! 10 ugliest celeb pets. Should they die first?
What the fuck is wrong with me?
That's good.
Snout and soul. Free poster. First impressions. How to charm, astound, to win over. Even the most jaded agent.
The cat that dodged inspection. All right.
What? Also, it was called Million Meow Meow, something like that.
Oh my god.
My perfect boy. My truest friend. Noble and fierce. You'll be inspected soon. But I won't wait for that.
I don't know what that means.
They're hiring agents. I've already applied. You're a good, good dog. I won't let them take you.
Did I sign up for something I'm not aware of? Did you talk about this when I wasn't in the room?
I think I discovered this game 2 or 3 days ago. Animal Inspector, you are agent 0315.
That's a terrible number to remember.
Hey, you don't have to remember it.
Oh,
it doesn't mean anything.
Okay.
No, we should read this.
Hello, my name is Martha.
Ignoring all of you. Oh,
wonderful to meet you, dear. Are you just starting out here as well? No. No.
Your voice acting is impeccable.
Lie.
I don't know anything.
Lie.
Drag a fish to my mouth. Which mouth?
The mouth in the dialogue box.
That's a mouth.
How exciting. Well, I'm very much looking forward to this. It will be good for me to get out of this. There's not much I should do. Do you see that young man over there?
I do now. Gee, thanks.
I tried talking to him earlier. He's a...
Alan!
I'm glad you're here. Enough of this. Work with you.
Great.
Well, near you? Why is
all
that
right,
funny?
Dialogue.
No, we need to read the dialogue. It's important. This is the point of the game. Oh my god.
Are you a new employee?
Employees. Okay.
Okay.
I knew it.
Well, I'm in charge here. Listen up. This job's pretty straightforward. Every day you'll get a stack of forms. Go through each one and stamp them. Approve good or useful animals.
Oh no! I don't like this at all!
Reject bad or useless animals.
Oh, they're all perfect!
Don't skip any.
I won't!
You're a genius.
We take this job very seriously. Oh yeah, one more thing. Please, make sure to comment on every animal you process.
You can't make me do that. No! Oh my god. Well, roommate, if you want to make me cry on camera, you might succeed
Explain
in this.
Explain your reasoning.
Jesus.
It's a legal thing.
No, it's a make Rachel's heart hurt thing.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess that's it.
I think
hey,
cool.
Answers are yeah, or okay, or cool.
I picked this. Oh, I have to drag it in his mouth.
Yeah, sure. Cool.
Do you want to do this one, Rachel?
It? Is there any training? Isn't there any training? Rubric or something?
No. Use your best judgment. I'll let you know if you've screwed up. But I try not to screw up. Okay, you'll each find a stack of forms at your desks. I'm starting you all off easy, but please be thorough.
He seems nice. You think so too, right?
No!
Just click and drag. What? Oh dear. Dot, dot, dot. Well, it seems that our day is about to begun.
You're terrible.
God, I hate him.
Is it time to go inspect some aminals? Do try to be a little more enthusiastic, dear.
You're not my real dad.
These animals need you. After all.
Alright, so first off, we've got a lowly pooch. His nature is goof. Utility is good for petting. We all love this fuzzy dog a lot. I don't know. Is he worth anything?
X. No!
Did you just get rid of
him? I mean, good for petting isn't really good for anything, really.
He's good for lots of
useless.
Things!
Useless.
What is petting for?
Great snuggler!
Yeah.
Wait.
You gotta drag the stamp onto it.
Drag both.
Click
the broom stamp.
This stamp?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Drag the broom?
Yeah, I guess it doesn't necessarily look like a stamp.
Can
and
you
then
also
you gotta
give
hit that
it
little.
Denied?
I don't know, I never tried.
This thing, the little
yep. Alright, so now we have a tiny cat. It's aloof. She didn't let me touch her until a few months ago, but now I pet her every day.
Just give her some time. Because Troll Kitty was also a shitbag, and now she's perfect and adorable and lovely.
Also deny it. Let's see what happens. No, I want to see what happens when
Find
it gets both.
Out.
Evil. All right.
House cat, timid. Utilities, reminder of simpler days. Civilian appeal. He easily becomes afraid, but this cat is good. He is family.
Duh.
You're the worst inspector.
Great job. Oh, dang.
Oh no! No, I really approve him, I promise. I really mean it. Okay.
Okay, that's all three.
So then now, okay, so
you hit the thumbs up.
Hit the thumbs up. Yeah, okay.
Okay. Welcome back, I guess. Pretty good job yesterday. Pretty good. Some of you, and I won't name any names, but you know who you are. Been a little too liberal with the approvals.
You don't know my life!
Whole point of this agency is
no.
to cull the herd. That means you can't just blindly let everything through. From now on, I'll need you all to reject at least one animal.
Quota!
Failure to do so will result in a strike. Okay, yeah, that's it. I didn't really think I needed to explain this, but, well, when you comment on forms, you should try to spell things correctly.
Dot is totally a word!
I mean, I know mistakes happen, but your job is kind of not to make mistakes. And you made some with that last batch.
Fuck your couch!
Maybe you don't think spelling is important, but you're a professional now, I guess. So, please try to act like it. Just a warning this time. But if this happens again, I'll have to give you a strike. And another thing. Okay, so this is just a warning, but please clean up your forms a little bit before turning them in.
That's what I get for doing multiple
no,
stamps,
no, no.
Cock.
There should be a little feather duster on your desk. Standard issue. So, use it maybe.
No.
What it does is when you click it, it shuffles, it stacks the papers nicely.
Seriously?
Seriously? Wow. Okay, well.
You know what? I'm with this guy. I was just called a cock for no reason. I didn't do anything wrong.
Real
you
reasons.
Called me a cock.
Any so that was him yelling at you for stamping it multiple times.
Yeah.
Don't let it happen. Also, please don't say if there are conflicting stamps on the same form, well, we have no choice but to assume rejection.
No!
Plus,
no!
Ink isn't cheap.
Ink is very cheap, thank you.
I'll let you off with a warning this time. Please don't let this happen again.
Man, hello again. How was your first day?
No.
lovely. My day was grand. Such wonderful and cute animals I had. Of course, I approved them all. Though, I guess I cannot do that anymore. Oh, I hate to bring this up, but I heard. Get it? Heard?
No, I didn't reject a kitty. I took it.
Did you reject a kitty? I wish you would not lie to me.
No.
I know you did it. Maybe I should not have asked. I guess I should get used to this kind of thing.
This is not okay.
Good luck today, dear. She says as she walks away with a knife in her kimono, ready to stab you at any point.
Hey, we never really talked earlier. I'm Alan. I don't think I'll be here very long. This is the bottom of the barrel stuff. Sincerely bad. Like, really, just the worst.
Was he just signing a letter?
Yeah. I'll feed the beetle to the froggy. Yeah. Yeah, you get me.
Bro.
Anyways, good to meet ya.
I like the little footprints in the background that are just like. Alright, so we have a snake. Nature quiet. Utility. No known use. This is my snake. It's very neat. My friend says are scared, but I am not. Shall we?
I feel like I'd probably rather reject this than anything else.
Really?
Whoa.
I mean, whoa. To be fair, the utility
because it
is...
doesn't have fur.
No, it has nothing to do with the fact that it doesn't have fur. You and I both know that.
I don't know.
I mean, utility is no known use.
Exactly.
Now, no other animal had use last time, and she approved them all. And now all of a sudden she's like,
fuck the snake.
Yeah, but
now I'm not allowed to approve them all.
So you're not even gonna give it a chance?
No, automatically I'm going to want to look at the first first pet that comes up and say, okay, what is the likelihood of the next pet being worse or better than this? And because its utility is no known use, its nature is quiet, it's a snake.
Its nature is quiet.
Don't interrupt me. I can presume that they are expecting me to reject this. Whereas the next animal or the next pet is going to be a little bit more.
I think it's a trick question.
If I accept this and then the next one is like, I'm the best puppy ever, I'm going to feel like a monster.
Well, I just want you to know that when you deny this, your heart is as cold as its.
Wait.
I gotta clean it up.
You also have to, you don't have to clean them up until you submit them, but you have to add inspector notes.
Oh, do I?
Yes. For everything.
Oh, jeez.
Why?
So why are you rejecting him?
Why am I oh, wait.
There you go.
See? Much better.
All right, we have a house cat, nervous, sheds a lot. I don't know. I actually said something similar with that cat. I was like, who'd make coats out of fur?
Good for pillow stuffing.
All right, we have an ancient hound, age 14. His nature is resigned. He's good for petting. He's gonna die soon. I don't know. Is he worth keeping around?
Akela, I just love him. I don't think I spelled that right.
I don't think you did.
Probably not. There you go.
It's funny, because look at that. The snake you denied was like the least bad of all of them. I told you it was a trick.
I actually think that the dog was probably the worst.
Oh yeah, the dog's the worst. The cat sheds, so people who are allergic to him.
It's true. So, there's a bit of a space concern. Basically, what I mean by that is there are some concerns about space. Specifically, the space all these animals are taking up. I guess what I'm trying to say is, please prioritize rejection of larger animals. All these things being equal, anyway.
That's not even close to accurate.
Anything close to human-sized. That's the size I'm talking about. Oh, a people-sized animal. Unbelievable. After all, the whole point of this is to, make space, I guess.
Oh, hello, dear. Sorry, but I'm a little down today. I heard that Alan has... Is it Alan? Yeah, has been rejecting all of his animals. She has an internal dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
I just do not agree with that. But he does not want to list end to me. He called me.
Keep it up!
He called you what? He called you well, dear? He said that I'm out of touch. Can you believe it?
Wow.
Yeah.
Goodness. Dear. Is it because of the way I'm saying she talks? I had thought you were kind. I
only
think maybe
animals.
You do not mean it. But even being rude only to get reaction is very cruel. Now I sound like a robot.
Yes, you do, and I'm ready to...
You're ready to what? Ready to what? Reject me?
Ready to rock!
You ready to reject me? Because I'm
also,
a fur?
I'm not proud of it. I rejected an animal. What?
Yep.
You're taking too long.
Not a cat, of course. Pretty slow.
Not a cat, of course. It was just fish.
Great.
And enemy of cats.
I mean...
What? But still, it does not feel good. Not at all. Dear, I just wanted to say thank you. I heard you had a cat in your last stack. Cats are just wonderful, because I'm a crazy cat lady. Not everyone understands them like us. They're very powerful creatures, you know. They shed a lot, but all that hair has a use.
What the fuck? Whoa! I did not get that response out of her last time.
That's so gross!
Oh, God! She's
ew,
the epitome
dude.
Of a crazy cat lady.
Called it.
Yeah, I'll see you later, you nutjob. How's it going? I'm getting rid of pretty much all my animals. Seriously, I've got no tolerance for useless things like your dick.
Wow.
You don't love this job, but I'm gonna do it well. See you around. Dude,
later,
you got a frog for your pet. Oh, that's a scuttlebutt.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Species, big pooch. Big pooch. Nature,
best
in charge.
Protector.
You remember what the instruction was at the last thing?
Oh,
you're supposed to reject all large human-sized animals.
Well, that is not a human size.
He's a big pooch, though.
Yeah, not human-sized pooch. It doesn't say it in his description.
Giant.
Wow. From great protector to giant monster. He is pretty old, anyway.
He is three!
Whatever.
Ant farm!
Educational utility. We aren't supposed to let the ants out in the classroom.
Great ant story.
Also, how can age be zero?
No, deny. There are more. There are so many ants on this planet that they outweigh us.
I'm ignoring you.
They are educational.
They take up so much space.
Tiny pup. Nature's squeaky. Fits in the lap.
Too squeaky.
The brutish pooch bit my left hand and drew blood. I think I'll need stitches. Did you hear that?
And cats are useless. Swanson.
Ah, there you go. Bam,
so, wait.
There you go.
Was that saying, like, you did this right?
No.
Was
that saying that that's, like,
oh.
complete the,
okay,
the stack.
I was gonna say. Ah.
Okay, so good morning. I just got word from the department head. Basically, well, they think you've all been doing great. Really great. So great, in fact, that they're bumping up the inspection quota.
No!
So...
Why be good at your job? That means you're gonna have more work.
Well, now you have five animals. Each to look through.
Dyslexia's a bitch, man.
Also, this means you each need to reject two.
No!
Because there are more. Because there are more. Because there are more animals. Oh, by the way. I appreciate you rejecting that big dog.
I hated it.
The dog? Yes. It was definitely a large animal. Maybe even the largest.
Except for the ants.
It's good to know someone was listening. So,
I hate listening.
Yeah, good job, I guess. Oh, in the future. Well, no, never mind.
Not!
Oh dear, that poor dog. Was it really the least useful animal? Wait, do they all, like, get a dog, or do they all get the same dog?
They're looking at what you did.
I'm not really a dog woman, but, well, I think it made its owners happy. This job is not what I thought it would be. Well, I don't know what you thought it was going to be. I'm trying my best to fare people.
Yep.
It's not very easy. Boss giving us lots of instructions. Instructions always not agree with. I'm being quick.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
Oh, man. This job.
Take it, Jewel.
I don't want to say this too loudly, but, well, it's boring, yeah? A real drag. Very repetitive. God, can you imagine doing this for the rest of your life? It gives you a real appreciation for education. Like, seriously, poor Martha. She's basically at the end of her life. She's ancient. So old. God, what the f- Look, like, just look at her. Why would you do that? That's so rude! Yikes. And yet, this is where everything's led for her. Man, yeah, real heavy, that's not me. Alright, I've got some issues with this. I don't think I'll be here long. Well, hey, I mean, this is what makes you happy, then cool.
Alright.
That's weird. I don't know why they had to do that.
It's because eventually you're gonna have to choose whether they make it through or not.
Right? I think they're making you not like him as a character.
Yeah.
So you'll see. So we have a standard female, feline, female.
Snugglebutt!
Snugglebutt. At.
Snugglebutt, hashtag Snugglebutt.
All right, we have another kitten, garden kitten. This one's meek, and it's soft. She's still finding her voice. I think she will do great things, Milton. I don't know, a cat without a voice.
She doesn't have much of a voice, and you know who else doesn't have much of a voice? Troll Kitty.
Yeah, and Troll Kitty is...
to be rejected.
Is useless. The is most useless cat.
Is... reminds me of my cat. Reject. Take that, Troll Kitty.
She's the worst.
Oh, this one's a Mauser. It's confident, self-cleaning. Even feeds himself.
Its
picture is also it going.
Needs minimal scritches.
Scritches. I think you might get the spelling issue with that one. Is scritches a word?
Scritches.
I don't think
it's actually a word.
I don't think that's a real word.
Just, you showed. Chris, what that means? Does that mean that the gamers can understand?
Shut.
Great.
No, do the thing.
I would have accepted him because of that awesome picture.
Echo's Oscar Twin, but he's very different.
All the Plex Dust.
Hey.
Echo is Oscar's twin, but he's very different. He hides
Dead
a lot.
Dead for allergies, cause dust.
There you go.
No, he collects dust. He walks around the house, he scoops it into a jar, and he goes, look, now you don't have to sneeze from this. He collects dust.
Elder cat, he's weary, he's wise, but he's also 9 years old. I call her the sage.
He's got like another 7 years in him, if, you know.
I think average cat lifespan is about 12 to 13 years.
That's still good. Still good.
Okay, so, I'm sorry to say, but old Mindy has come down with the flu.
Who?
Oh, you know, Mindy. Old Mindy.
What is happening?
Everyone knows Mindy. Come on, in any case. Well,
all right.
Someone needs to take her place in the cages. And today that someone is Alan.
Yeah? Okay, well, cool. I'm up for anything.
Alan's been chosen because of his exemplary.
That is spelled wrong.
Well, that's...
Exemplary.
That's why I stumbled on it, to show exemplary. exemplary?
There we go.
Performance here in these past few weeks.
Right on.
There you go.
Ah, I fucked up.
You all have been doing well. So no need to worry about increased quotas. Good work out there, everyone.
Oh dear, what do you think about that? Well, I'm sure glad that I am not going. The cages are no place for me, dear. I have heard some bad things about that place. Very scary things, things that are not good at all, dear. By the way, dear, you did something bad, very bad.
Oh, I rejected the cat.
I thought that I would feel angry. And I do. But mostly I am sad. There is no point to what you did. You do not want to talk. I do not want to talk right now. Oh, man.
Oh, man. Not exactly sure what to expect, but anything's better than doing paperwork all day. Honestly, I'm pumped about it. Very excited. Thrilled. This is the beginning of good things for me. I can feel it. There is way too much dialogue.
And freak.
It's really, really annoying.
I disagree. I think that's the whole point of the game. It's half the point of the game.
There's a lot of repetition.
Some of the dialogue does feel a little redundant. I'll give you that much. Adventurous outdoor cat, age 9, tired of bird corpses.
Get out of here, cat.
You know, I like all the cat pictures because every single one of them are alive.
It's pretty appropriate for cats. It must have been fun to get all the animal photos for this game. You think they just like went around to all their friends and just snap photos of their pets?
Yeah, I can see it.
Desperately needs cuddles.
I'm careless dog to take some space. Like, what?
Ooh, I wonder if you're gonna get slapped for him.
No,
because he's big.
It's cuddles.
There it is.
Man, arrogant. Does his job.
No room.
He is human-sized. Oh, dang. Different land tortoise. Eats discarded fruit. Devo here has been in our family since before the name meant anything.
Better.
Except for turtle poop. Goldfish. Golden fish. Nature cold. Calms children. I think when I got this one, I was like,
I think
accepted, good for controlling children. I think you might need to reject too. I don't remember if they said that. Goldfish. More like good to feed the other animals with. Parrot, unforgiving, bites other animals. Damn thing squawks, it doesn't stop. Haven't slept through the night in 4 years.
Fucking hate
wow.
birds. I hate birds
wow.
so much. They're my least favorite thing.
There you go. Good job, you did it. You killed the animals. Well, I think I speak for all of us when I say documentaries are great. Documentaries are important government tools. They show the public that we're just like them. My favorite documentary is... Well, I forget the title.
Of course you do.
But it's about a wolf raised by geese.
Do I know this one? Is this a thing?
The wolf grows up and then eats the geese.
I feel like this isn't a real thing anymore.
It's a message we can all learn from. In any case, there's a reason I'm bringing this up. Believe it or not, they're making a documentary about this department.
What?
So in order to present us all in the best possible light, I'm asking you, well, telling you to approve all of your animals today.
But they're all gonna suck.
Understood?
Yes. Yeah. And then deny
Good.
Every single one.
Great.
Fight the man.
I'm not gonna fight
no.
the man.
And,
no.
And now
deny
before
everyone.
You start your day. It seems that Alan is no longer with us.
No!
Everything's fine, but... well, there was an issue in the cages.
Oh, is that my fault?
Just a slight mix-up. It's nothing much to worry about. But, well, that's... blah, blah, he was a good employee.
This was a good one. He was a good employee.
A good boy. He'll be missed.
Oh, dear. What could have happened to Alan? I do not like him much, but this is very concerning. Dear, I told you I had a bad feeling in place. Hope that boss does not ask me to go there. I am a little, dear, worn down.
Worn down, dear?
This documentary, very exciting though, think will be.
What?
To be honest, I'm very happy about it. I mean, we do not have to reject any animals. I will tell you though, I'm getting a little worried about my cats. They have not come up for inspection yet.
I'm gonna reject all.
Very
of that.
Anxious.
Oh my god.
I just want them to be okay. Dear, we need to talk. That cat you rejected, I know it was an outside cat, and I know there are many prejudices against such cats, but dear, stop calling me dear. Do the opposite of everything she asks from here on. All
yeah.
Cats, no cat is better than any other.
All cats should treat people.
And all of them should be denied. Even if a cat is mostly outside, it gets very dirty. What? That cat is still worth loving. Oh. I hope you understand. Well,
dear.
Deny everything. Seriously, deny everything.
No, puppy.
Deny
dog.
Everything.
No, he's
everything.
So snuggly.
Deny everything.
So green. No.
Be like, this inspection is ridiculous.
Well,
deny.
Do you want to get fired? You can't save your dog if you get fired.
I don't want to
get
fired.
The whole point is this is that you're trying to save your dog.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's why we got this job, is so that we can protect our dog. That's why it started us off with that dialogue. That's why we were saying, you're a good boy, you don't deserve this. They're hiring inspectors, I'm going to become one so that I can save you.
Right, I remember that now. Yeah, deny everything.
No,
you need to fix the world.
Nice cat. This nature's nice. Species, feline. Tiny little baby meows.
Tiny little baby meows.
Very nice. We have a fish that broods. It's food for snakes. It's a great utility.
Great food.
Too bad you killed the only snake.
Did I?
No more snakes.
Good for...
fur babies.
Good for self-esteem.
Fur babies?
Fur babies.
Fur babies. Good for self-esteem. Because you're always better than a fish.
It's true.
Mysterious bird. Nature silent. Strange smell. She's sleeping.
That is definitely a dead bird. You're about to accept.
Are you,
sure
you going to deny
dead,
her?
And then you accept. you know what
you know. When I accepted her, I was like, good for controlling crazy people. My first playthrough of this, I took a very militaristic approach, so my rationale was whether or not they could be weaponized. So anytime I got an animal that was like, bites other animals, I was like, approved, could be used for future combat. And I always got strikes for it. I was sad.
You shouldn't deny the dead bird. All right.
Well, D-Day is come and gone. And, well, that's Doc Day, by the way. Documentary Day. Because they were filming a documentary. Oh, documentary starts with D. Okay, well, anyways. I have good news and bad news. The good news is that the filming went well. They got all the shots they needed. They are done with this office. Bad news is that we're now extremely behind on our rejection quotas.
Damn it. I get the feeling that no matter what I did, it was going
to follow this pattern.
To follow this pattern.
Yes. Now the difference though is that the people that you're talking to change. So for example, Alan, if he was still alive, would have been like, this is totally what's gonna happen if after we accept all these animals, you're gonna have to reject all of them. And this happens and he's like, called it. So their dialogue actually gives you a lot of clues. Not sure if I could do it. Maybe all of our animals will be bad today.
That's not gonna happen. No, bitch, I'm just gonna fuck with you. I swear to God, cat, eat the goddamn fish.
Eat it! Eat it!
Eat it! Blah, 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 blah. That's... there are lots.
You can read still.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Oh, well.
No, that's okay. You know what? She... She gets mad at me every time I read. I don't
Total
know why.
Total sucker.
Oh, you're gonna do it.
I'm supposed to.
You are supposed to. Can't save our pup if we don't do it. Basic dog. Forgetful. No known use. One time she barked at a rock.
Far too long.
Fool.
Fool of a took.
Cat's meek medicinal properties. This cat's my baby. Oh, I just love her so much. Martha.
Take. Suck it, Martha. Yeah.
Why would you do that to me?
When I played that, I was playing at my desktop and the screen is like really close to my face because I do things without my glasses on. And that happened and I was like, oh god, what the fuck?
Maybe it's too much.
Maybe it's too much?
It eats too
much. Oh, it eats too much, yeah. Screw those fish. Yeah, dude. It's so like little, but it's I feel like it's upsetting if you're like if you don't hate Martha at least, because you're just like, oh god.
It steals a sense of joy in others. Rejected.
Man, there you go.
Clean it up. That's fair.
I don't know why you have to clean it up. I feel like that's superfluous.
It's adding an extra step, which just gives you a general challenge.
So,
but you get so used to it that it's...
I wouldn't say that it gives you an additional challenge, but it's a way of making sure that you have to go through and be like, is this really what I want to do?
It's memory management is basically what it boils down to. This design philosophy for this game is very similar to Papers, Please. And the idea is that the game is challenging because you're presented with so many rules that it's hard to manage all of them. And eventually... you could just forget to do the simple thing and get screwed over for it.
It's very art housey with only like the slight chance of actually like losing, it seems.
Mm-hmm.
And that makes it more of an arc than an actual like competitive game.
Yeah.
Like.
But it's for that reason we're playing this game on the show instead of Papers, Please, because Papers, Please is not really suitable for a let's play. If we do that, we need a third person that's just playing the game.
Yeah, that's true.
Hang in there.
But remember to hang in there.
I'm just skipping through a lot.
That being said, Mindy is sick again.
God fucking damn.
Good old Mindy. She's really been sick a lot recently.
I work at a
suspicious. Well, Alan took over last time, and well, he's not with us anymore. So it's your turn. You'll take over for Mindy today. Just head down to the cages. I'll follow you down in a bit with blah blah blah.
With instructions.
Dear, I know you were only doing your job, but I just cannot look at you right now. You could have saved her. It was a lot to ask of you, but I still hoped.
Suck it, Mindy.
Oh my god, was that her cat that I rejected?
Yeah.
That was what I was
That's
trying to tell
I
you.
That's why I said suck it, Mindy. Yeah.
Or Martha, I mean.
Martha, yeah. And then now you get to go into the cages and she gets to vote on you.
Welcome to the cages. You're probably wondering where all the actual cages are.
Kinda?
Well, rest assured, there are definitely some cages in here. They're probably behind a few more doors. You'll see them soon. But first, I'm sure you have a few questions. Maybe you want to ask what this place is.
You know, I am a little curious. No, God, motherfucker. Give me goddamn
Do better, mo better.
I thought
You're
so.
You're better.
Do better, mo better. Well, I'll tell you. You've been part of a little experiment. Ooh. Yes, well, I guess it's more of a big experiment. But anyways, I have a few questions for you. And then I'll explain everything.
I feel like that's not what's gonna happen.
Please, try to answer as honestly as possible.
Oh, God.
Please. First question. Have you noticed anything odd during your time here?
Yeah. Martha's a goddamn bitch.
I see. Martha, interesting.
Alan is just useless.
Next question. Is the goal of this organization clear to you?
Not really.
Okay. Let me just mark that down.
Oh, I don't like that now.
Third question.
I want to go back.
Third question. Would you describe everyone here as normal?
No, you're a fucking weirdo, brah.
Oh, I'm the weird one. Would you describe Martha as abnormal?
Yes. Oh, I was, like, really terrible to happen to Martha.
I see. Well, I think we're just about done here. Thanks very much for your time. So, I guess you've noticed there's something funny going on. Well, I'll explain a few things. So first of all, Alan, rest in peace. Alan wasn't a real person.
What the
what I mean by that is Alan wasn't always the way he was. The Alan you were interacting with was actually an animal. I know, crazy, right? Shit's not a dog specifically.
He's a dog?
I know, neat, right?
No!
Yeah, well, oh, I thought you were going to say yes. I think it's neat. Anyway, look, we've been researching how to train animals to do menial labor, like your job. Stamping forms, we can train animals to do it.
You can't train a cat to do shit.
Of course. To do that, we have to set them up with nicer brains.
Nicer.
And we seed those brains with human memories, so they can actually function. In Alan's case, we gave him Alan's memories. Alan the dog's case.
That's why he was so dumb.
We gave the dog Alan to the memories of the human Alan.
Oh. Wait.
Or that dog Alan, the memories of the human Alan. Not that the dog Alan's name was originally Alan too. I mean, that would be a weird coincidence. Anyways, when you have someone's memories, you kind of freak out if you don't actually look like them. So we make that happen. Look, I won't get into the specifics, but like, technology is pretty advanced these days. It's crazy, right? So we can basically make an animal pass as human. Makeup. And we don't have to pay them.
Woo!
Even better. So all these pets we've been rejecting, they're untapped workforce. They're an untapped workforce.
Oh, man.
And we're tapping them. Tap, 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 of course. You did notice that something was off.
Yeah, because you're tapping the animals that are being rejected.
We still have some work to do.
Some serious negging, man, okay?
But yeah, it makes sense.
If they tap the accepted ones?
No.
Okay, well, we'll just tap you then. I mean, look, I don't mean to imply this idea is bulletproof, but you have to admit it's pretty solid.
Just say.
Okay, hold up. What's your problem? Name one issue with this plan. Oh my. Just one.
It's the only option I got.
I guess it's a little absurd how much money we've put into this. And we probably won't ever really make it back.
Scientists never do.
But money isn't everything. Some of mankind's greatest achievements weren't profitable.
Most of them were eventually profitable to some degree.
That's why it says some and not most. So if that's all you've got to complain about.
Morals!
Allow
me to stand on my soapbox.
Well, I guess we were experimenting with people's pets. And we kind of wiped out the wilderness a little.
Fuck you guys.
So that's not great. And I mean, if we're giving an animal someone's memories.
Just fuck right the fuck up.
Is it really so different than us at that point?
Yes.
And what would happen if someone met their animal clone? That's kind of spooky, to be honest.
What game are you making me play? This is so weird.
But that's the price we pay for progress. The greater good. It'll all be worth it in the end. Of course! I mean, probably, right? Maybe? Oh. Well, I guess there's not any obvious benefit. But we're in too deep at this point. We just gotta keep pushing through. You have to agree with that, right? We're balls deep.
No!
Oh, well, look, there are some issues here. Like, it's kind of weird that we're using animals for this.
Yes.
Robots would probably have made more sense.
Obviously.
Kind of a strange use of technology.
God damn it.
And I mean, what's the end goal here?
I don't goddamn fucking know, bro.
Once all the jobs are done by animals, then what?
Nothing. We die.
Plus, if the animals think they're human, then...
Oh, God.
We probably will have to pay them. Okay, so this whole plan is a little weird.
Thank you.
Just a tiny bit. But I think we've covered all this flaws at this point.
I don't think that's true.
I mean, every plan has its downsides. There aren't many any absolutes in this world. This plan may not have been perfect. But really, what is? So you know, see now, right? You're on board with our strategy.
If it means I can avoid dialogue.
Perfect! I'm glad we had this talk. Oh, but hold up for a sec. Just wanted to say you've been a good employee.
Don't lie.
You haven't caused much trouble. That's true, you haven't gotten any strikes. This boat ain't rocking. Well, anyways, I heard you have a dog.
My snuggle butt!
I think we can pull a few strings.
Hell yeah!
That dog will be just fine. I don't think you need to worry.
Woo!
No problem. Happy to do it. Keep up the good work out there.
Now your dog's being held hostage.
No! Now it's gonna make me look at all the animals I reject.
Look at all those animals you killed.
No.
Six.
Seven. I killed a lot of cats. I think that's what's important to note here.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
Okay, so to wrap things up, because this is the end of the game. What are your final thoughts? I mean, obviously it's pretty messed up, but. What's interesting, though, is that you took the, like, I reject your reality approach, and I'm actually really curious to see what the end would have been had you kept rejecting it. So I guess that's, like, something for everyone else to kind of poke around and play with this game and see.
Yeah, no, I mean, there's obviously a lot of possibilities in it.
Mm-hmm. But I think the one thing that we didn't see a ton of in this game that I really, really was impressed by is that the game anticipates a lot of different things from you. If you swear, it'll give you a strike.
Really? Yeah. I didn't swear. Maybe that's why.
Sometimes your wording will actually matter. If you insult someone, maybe that one didn't do.
Yeah, stamps kind of messed me up.
Yeah, there's so many little things that they'll pick up on that they'll be like, no.
That's some seriously intense programming to be able to pick up on all that.
Yeah, I thought it was actually kind of cool.
Yeah. We discussed it that the constant berating of dialogue and repetition is what really got to me, I think, ultimately. And I think that they kind of ruined it at the end.
By making it so crazy?
No, well, I mean, that too, but they went from narrative to just explanation. It started off very, like, it was like narrative. It didn't have to show you that you were rejecting her cat, but you got to make that decision. Like, you understood. You didn't have to be told, man, that was messed up or good or bad when you were making the decision. And then at the very end, he comes in and says, this is what's going on. How do you feel? Do you feel that way? Do you feel like you should feel that way? Or is it okay for you to feel like it? All of a sudden, it went from, this is a narrative piece, like, this is what you do and this tells the story because you're doing it, to let me tell you everything and just vomit the information on you.
That's true. Do you think you would have felt better about it had you kind of, if you had to like finagle that information out of him?
Absolutely, 100%.
In a game like this, I feel like, originally I was really against the dialogue, and I understand, now that I've gotten to the end of the game, I understand the purpose of it and why it was beneficial. But instead of having it be more heavily centered around gameplay and choosing and doing all this stuff, there was a lot more dialogue. It felt really even. I felt like my time was evenly split.
And that's pretty fair.
I think that's kind of crummy.
What do you mean?
The dialogue isn't necessarily part of the game. Like, yeah, you're learning stuff and you're finding stuff out, but so half the game, I just was sitting there just clicking a mouse. And that's not fun nor interactive.
I guess I could kind of see that. I think that sort of is part of the argument of the right time and place for dialogue in games. And I think, maybe we'll just always disagree on this, but I think this is a game where it does have the time and the place. And I do think it was redundant at times, and it could have been kind of more concise.
Yeah, concise and clean.
And I think the point was to give those characters some personality, right? But I think it was a little overdone.
Right, so do that at the beginning of the game. And I guess I'm just a little bit more of a traditionalist in that way, is that if you're going to play a game, you're going to get all that dialogue and all the exposition out at the beginning. And then you're able to play the game, and like you'll have some dialogue interspersed out, and then maybe at the end you'll have like a little bit more.
Yeah.
But it felt like there was way more dialogue at the end of the game than there was anywhere else. And
that's
so
true.
When I was sitting there, I was like waiting for there to be like some big thing that I'm supposed to do, but I'm just clicking through dialogue.
So it was kind of anticlimactic.
Yeah.
Is kind of what you're getting at.
That is actually fair. One final like set of cards or a card that you have to decide approve or deny on, like that would have been the way to end it.
I agree. Like that would have been really, it's like, all right, based on the decisions you've made, now you gotta do this, and it's like, I don't really remember all the decisions I made.
Yeah, or even doing something with that final interaction with the science guy, like I forget his name already, if you even had one. But if we had the same mechanic, right, where we're stamping approval or disapproval on a card, but maybe do that something with the interaction with that guy, the scientist, kind of switch it up. Maybe not make it about animals, but make it more about that interaction.
What if they had revealed that scientist guy, he was your dog, and you had to choose whether to accept or deny him, right?
That would be kind of crazy.
That would have made the player like sit back and go,
you're a monster, but you're still my dog. Oh God, what do I do?
Right? Or if you really wanted to get it on another level, if you wanted the player to interact with the other characters, have them have to collaborate with that character. And so you have to be thinking like, okay, how is this character gonna respond to this? And so what should I do in that mode? That could also be really interesting.
That's fair. I do think that your interaction with the other characters was sort of insubstantial in that way. Like,
no, it was just dialogue. It didn't.
Right, they give you hints and stuff, but ultimately like their fate doesn't really change the game.
Yeah.
Cool, any other thoughts?
I think this game has a lot of potential to, like, is this a fully released, like, Dunzo game?
I mean, it's on itch.io right now, and it's free with a suggested donation.
Okay.
I don't think the developers are planning on making more of it. I think it was supposed to be sort of like a, I don't know, like a proof of concept, sort
of. I mean, I feel like this game could be a lot more enjoyable and a lot more fun with just, like, a little kind of beefing up in some parts and pulling back from other aspects of it. You and I disagreed on the whole dialogue thing.
Mm-hmm.
There are some things that it was totally appropriate and a really good tool in showing the kind of game that you want to play, but there were times, like at the end, it was just...
Yeah.
It's too much.
So question of the day. I think we should ask them what they think about the dialogue.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Do you think it helped? Do you think it hindered? How do you think that it could have?
What do you think its strength was, and where do you think it could have improved?
Yeah.
Do you approve or deny this dialogue?
All right. Well, thank you for watching, everybody, and we'll see you in the archives.
Deuce.
Adios.